Hello everyone, Brian Frio here with Hypo Real and Facts, and in this episode, the facts that we are going to talk about is the origins of three topics, that is, piggy bank, pig-headed, and pigs in a wing. We're going to discuss where these origins came from. So, if you haven't caught on already, we are going to talk a lot about pigs. I did have a pig nose to go along with this episode, but I couldn't find it. So, without pulling your pigtail anymore, let's get to it. Number one, piggy bank. The origin of piggy banks dates back nearly 600 years in time before real banks even existed. Before the creation of modern style banking institution, people commonly stored their money at home, not under the mattress or hay rack, but in common kitchen jars. During the Middle Ages, metal was expensive and seldom used for household wares. Instead, dishes and pots were made of an economical orange-colored clay called pig. Whenever folks could save an extra coin or two, they dropped it into one of their clay jars, a pig pot. Vowels in early English had different sounds than they do today, so during the time of the Saxons, the word pig would have been pronounced pug. But as the punctuation of Y changed from a U to an I, pig eventually came to be pronounced about like pig. Over the next 200 to 300 years, as the English language evolved, the clay pig and the animal piggy came to be pronounced the same, and Europeans slowly forgot that pig once was pronounced pug. So in the 19th century, when English potters received requests for piggy banks, they started producing banks shaped like pigs. This clever, accidental visual pun appealed to customers and delighted children. However, early form piggy banks didn't have any holes on the bottom you could screw loose to get the coins out, so you had to bust the piggy bank in pieces in order to get all the coins out. Which, sadly, has not left too many of those old antique piggy banks around. I would like to thank my friend Risa for giving me this idea to look up the idea of where piggy banks came from. If you have any ideas of origins you would like to know, please leave it in the comments below. But thank you, Risa, for giving me this idea. Number two, pig-headed. This word originated around 1610. At first, it meant having a head like a pig, but then around 1788, the meaning changed. If you were called pig-headed around 1788, it meant someone was calling you stupid. Basically, it meant you would always do the opposite of what someone told you to do.
You are stupid! 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 And don't forget, you are stupid!
And lastly, pigs in a whistle. Now, I haven't really heard this term so much, probably because it originated in the UK and I live here in America. If I was in the UK, then I'd probably hear it a lot. If you live in the UK and you've heard this term pig in a whistle a lot, please let me know. Basically, many people thought it meant getting your drink on. You were gonna go to the bar and get your drink on. People thought this term originated because it was named after a bar named Pig in a Whistle. However, there hasn't been any records or proof of any bars with that name. But there was a poem written in 1794 titled Herst Rig, and it goes like this. How he did visit Bedlam, fool men, and disputed with Grisham, school men, discoursing of their pigs and whistles, and strange experiments of muscles, of resurrection of rats, and of the language used by cats, when in the night they go into canteen, and fall a scolding and a pranting. Now the part in the poem that says pigs and whistle meant to fall in ruins. How? I don't know, but poems back in the day meant a lot of different meanings. So, those are the origins of those words. If you have any other requests for origins of words or phrases, please let me know in the comments below. Thank you, and I'll see you again.